Guys, if you're anything like me, you love your M4 Mac Mini. It's powerful, it is compact, it's very reasonably priced, but it's got one glaring weakness, and that is the number of high-speed bandwidth ports that are on the back, either the Thunderbolt 4 or Thunderbolt 5, depending on whether you have the Pro or not. But today, we're gonna solve that issue once and for all, because I have a dock that's gonna change everything. This is the brand new Anker Prime Thunderbolt 5 dock from Anker, and is poised to give your Mac Mini all the ports that it needs. Let's get into it. Now, for the sake of transparency, I am partnering with Anker on this video, which means that this is provided by Anker. Now, I know that this is a big problem for Mac Mini owners, which is why I am interested in looking at it. So I hope that you understand that, and let's see what's inside the box. Now, this is one of the first wave of Thunderbolt 5 docks in the industry. And if we look here, what makes Thunderbolt 5 so special is that it's gonna give you 120 gigabits per second of max data transfer if you have a Thunderbolt 5 compliant device. That means you need the dock, that means you have a computer such as the M4 Mac Mini Pro, M4 Mac Studio, even the M4 MacBook Pro in some versions as well, in addition to having an accessory like this OWC Thunderbolt 5 drive that I have here. All these things are gonna work together to give you that max throughput. Now, this is a 14-in-1 docking station. It supports up to 2 8K displays, as well as Thunderbolt 5. Now, it is worth noting that this will also charge your device up to 140 watts max. So if you have the 16-inch MacBook Pro, plenty of power to go around. This is honking. This is pretty big. This is pretty significant. Of course, the size does not matter. You're not really taking this with you when you, I guess it is kind of portable in that respect. But if we look at it here, compared against the Mac Mini, they're about 15% bigger in terms of total volume. I'll get the exact volume measurements and place them on screen. Speaking of things that are both small and powerful, click subscribe, turn on notifications so you can get more Mac Mini content just like this. But they're relatively palmable. If you look at them side by side, there's not necessarily a big difference, but let's see here the ports on the front. We have a 3.5 millimeter jack. We have two USB-C ports, which will give you 45 watts total between both of these, and it's capable of delivering 10 gigabits per second in terms of data charging. This is a USB 3.1, and it's 10 gigabits per second as well for the USB-A port. Here on the bottom, we have some fans. We have some fans on the back. Here it says Prime. On the side, we have a TransFlash card reader as well as a full SD card reader. Now, if you consider yourself an ultimate fan of Apple amongst your friends, you wanna check out my ultimate Apple desk setup. I'll link that at the end of this video so you can see all of my favorite Apple memorabilia. So here in the back, we have two USB-A ports, which are gonna be at 10 gigabits per second. We also have a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet jack here. We have an HDMI 2.1, a DisplayPort 2.1, as well as the upstream Thunderbolt connection to your computer and two downstream ports. Now here on the bottom, what is interesting about this is that the entire power supply is built into this. So you might have a little bit thicker of a brick, but you don't need to carry a honking power supply, which I absolutely hate those giant power supplies. GaN technology, which Anker is really, you know, leading the charge, no pun intended, which they're actually a big part of, you see that not really in a lot of docks. I saw it in a dock maybe a couple years ago, but that was the first one that I saw. But this is the first Thunderbolt 5 dock that I have seen that has GaN technology built into it, which means that the power brick is integrated in here, which really is gonna account for the weight. Ooh, what's this here? You have a nice power button here on the top. And when you plug this in, I would assume that when you plug it in and power it on, you can also power it on from here as well. There's this kind of power up animation in these LEDs that come up. Oh, it does. It kind of looks like Kit from Knight Rider. It's actually very cool. So let's power that back on again. Now I'm gonna plug in my OWC Thunderbolt 5 SSD as well as the included Thunderbolt 5 cable. Let's see how fast the data transfers are. Okay, I'm going to select the drive location, select target drive. And we're gonna go here, OWC, and start. Now going through here, it's getting almost 4,700 write over 5,000 read, which is pretty freaking fast. There's a little bit of headroom that's gonna be used to manage the device, but this is still quite beefy. Now let's just try and copy something here. All right, so I'm gonna copy this 83 gigabyte file. I'm gonna paste a copy on this drive that I have connected. That is incredible. It's moving this so fast. That's the great thing about Thunderbolt is that you get that guaranteed bandwidth of up to 80 gigs per second for Thunderbolt 5. So if you have the need, it really is just something that's, I think, unparalleled in terms of transfer. Definitely a value add, but it will cost you. Now, who should consider buying Anker's Thunderbolt 5 dock? So one, you want to make sure that you have a Thunderbolt compliant device. It's got to be Thunderbolt 5. Thunderbolt 4 would work as well. Thunderbolt 3, you're probably not going to get the best use out of it. But if you have a device that's compliant, that's where you're going to see the most amount of applicability. You're going to get two downstream ports to your peripherals and then one upstream port to your Mac. Specifically, the Mac Mini, in my opinion, has the best amount of applicability because it's already port limited. You're also adding two USB ports here on the back, one on the front, as well as two USB-C ports here on the front. You're also adding an SD card and a transflash card here as well. And you're getting the ability to charge your Mac at 140 watts, though if you have a Mac Mini, that's not something that's really applicable because the Mac Mini has an independent power supply. It would be cool if you could power the Mac Mini, but you can't. Okay, Mac Mini owners, I wanna know from you, do you think that Anker's Thunderbolt 5 dock is worth it at $399? It's adding a number of ports, giving you a lot of flexibility that you don't have today, and a number of ports that you don't have today, especially the SD card reader, transflash card reader, TF reader. So I think it's probably worth it at $399, but I wanna hear your opinion. If you wanna pick it up, there's a link down in the video description that you can go ahead and pick it up, or you can search Anker Prime TB5 on Google or wherever you're at, and you'll find more information about it. If you wanna get more content just like this, hit subscribe. My name is Mike, and guys, I will talk to you in the next one.